Today's topic of the video is going to be if Democrats take back the House of Representatives, their majority will be slim. It will not be a supermajority. It will be nothing compared to what we saw in 2008 because the Democrats are at such a disadvantage with a whole number of states that have been gerrymandered, both in the favor of the Republicans and Democrats, which doesn't really help the Democrats improve if they're already winning every congressional seat in the state. And when we look at a number of other races, areas that are controlled by Republicans, we see a number of these states with gerrymandering for the Republicans. And it's not just a Republican issue, but usually the political party in power stays in power by using this technique, which is why the 2018 governor elections with 35 races is being watched very closely. I actually think it's 36 races. So 36 races are being watched very closely because they will be the governors in when redistricting occurs every 10 years, which will happen in 2020 when the census comes around. So looking at this House chance, we're using the crosstab 2018 midterm forecast. And right now, the Democrats have a 74% chance of winning. So that must be really good, right? We look at this map. Democrats have a number of pickups outlined by the black. Wow, the Democrats have a 74% chance of winning. But when we scroll down just a tad and we go ahead and look at the projected seats, the Democrats only have 229 seats. They need 218 to win a majority, only 11 more than the majority. But then we go back and say, oh, let's take a look at the 2006 or 2008 representative election. This is 2010, the last time a Republican wave occurred. Actually, 2014 was a Republican wave, but 2010 was the last time it was a wave in the House. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at the map that we had in 2006 when we had a huge Democratic wave where not a single Democratic incumbent lost to a Republican challenger. When we just look at this map, well, there are no Republican gains except for maybe in some open seats that I probably can't even see them on the map because there are so few, or there may be none. But right now, look at this map. Well, the Democrats did pretty well, but their majority pretty much came from the South. Let's take a look at the map right here. This is the map in the 111th Congress right after 2008, leading into the 2010 midterms. Look at the South. This is when the Democrats held a majority in the United States House of Representatives of 257 seats. That is a considerable amount. Keep in mind, this was the election that Obama got elected. So down in the South, this is where the Democrats really focused on a lot. The Rust Belt, the South, this is where they had a number of their members coming from. Yes, it came from the Rust Belt and it came from parts of the West, but it wasn't as heavily centered around areas like the West and the Northeast as it is today. Even Delaware had an incumbent Republican in the House of Representatives in 2008. 2010 rolls around. Well, now we have a whole lot more red. Look at that South. We see a lot of Democratic incumbents, even in the Rust Belt, even the Rust Belt and the Sun Belt, a number of Democratic incumbents. Even this candidate right here in Idaho's first district was the Democrat, the only Democrat endorsed by the NRA, and he still lost. Down here, all Democratic incumbents that gave the Democrats a very big majority in the House, gone. The Republicans picked up, let's go ahead and see how many seats exactly. Go back to 2010, the Republicans picked up a total of 63 seats, giving them the majority of 242 seats. That's larger than what the Democrats are expected to get come 2018. So where does this come from? It comes from gerrymandered districts. We look at this, the Republicans did phenomenal, considering that a number of these races were gerrymandered in the favor of the Democrats in 2010, and they were somehow able to get 242 seats. The Democrats are only expected to get 229, even with 74% chance of winning the House of Representatives back into their majority. So these numbers aren't really correlating either. We go ahead and take a look at the 2016 representatives election. The Republicans got 241 seats, and the Democrats have 194, up 6. Yet somehow the popular vote was only a 1.1% lead for Republicans in the United States House of Representatives popular vote. It was a little bit more in the 2014 election, which was a red wave year, but the Democrats had the majority in the popular vote here by 1.2% in 2012. Yet somehow the Republicans held on to around 50% of the seats, and the Democrats did not carry a clear amount. I mean, they did not beat them, even though they won the popular vote, and that's exactly what happened in 2016. In the presidential election, which is why a lot of Democrats call on things like the abolishment of the Electoral College, which wouldn't affect the House of Representatives elections, but it's just an issue that's very prominent amongst the Democrats. So losing in the popular vote or only losing by a couple points, yet losing by considerable margins in a number of the House races and current composition, it just doesn't look good for the Democrats. So let's go ahead and take a look down here. Look at the South. This is Republican territory. These were also Republican states back in 2016 and 2012 and 2008. Yet somehow in the 2008 composition, the Democrats had a number of their representatives coming from the South. They no longer have that. When the Democrats had the opportunity to take back the majority in 2006, well, here are the 2006 House elections. Where do you see a number of Democrats? North and South Dakota. The South. The Sun Belt. That's where some Democrats are coming from. Yes, they come from the North, but they come from states like West Virginia, Indiana, a number of other races. The South was an area that the Democrats really had. And this was an area where some of these states even had more Democratic representatives than Republican ones, yet they had Republican presidential election electors. Essentially, they voted for Republicans in the presidential election. Yet somehow, 2010 rolled around, and all these states flipped back to the Republicans. You look at this map, a lot more red than what you see down here, especially looking at the South. Arkansas, Mississippi, Tennessee, North Carolina, South Carolina. Keep your eye on those five states. Boom. Tennessee almost got rid of almost all their Democrats. North Carolina had less than they had before. South Carolina had much less than they had before. Mississippi only held on to one. Arkansas only held on to one. And right now, if we look at the 2016 House of Representatives, Arkansas has zero. Tennessee has two. North Carolina, I believe, has three. South Carolina has one. And we look at this map, well, where did these Democratic incumbents go? Some of them flipped to the Republican Party. Some of them lost re-election and have no real chance of winning again. And that's bad news for the Democrats. If they want a chance of taking back the majority, they're going to need to be able to win in areas that they could win before. It all comes down to the candidates. We see it in Tennessee with the Senate election here. Before, this race was solidly Republican, but now all of a sudden it's actually leaning Democratic or a toss-up seat, depending on who you're asking, because a former governor is running in the seat here. So a number of these races will come down to the candidates, especially since we look at the approval polls that show – sorry, not the approval polls, the generic ballot polls that show the Democrats ahead by a considerable amount. 47.9% for the Democrats, 39.5% for the Republicans. There's no reason why the Democrats shouldn't be winning by margins they won back in 2006, except for the fact that they are no longer winning in areas that they used to. And even in 2006, holding on to the South, they still only carried 233 seats, four more than what they're expected to get in this election season. So – again, looking at this map, yes, they hold on to the South, but they weren't winning in areas like they were before. Delaware was red. Most of New Jersey was red. Parts of New York were red. We look over here. I believe all of Nevada, except for one district, was red. Yes, they held their Southern presence, but even though the last Democratic wave year, the Democrats did not have a clear majority like the Republicans were able to get in 2010. 2008 was probably the last time that was not a midterm year that the Democrats were able to carry a number of races that gave them 257 seats. Yet all of a sudden, 2010 rolled around and the Republicans won nearing the Democratic margin back in 2008, where the Democrats had 257 seats and the Republicans 242 now. So they didn't have as much as the Democrats, but they flipped a whole number of seats, 63. To be exact, flipping back the majority. Every seat in the darker red is a seat that is flipped from the Democrats. We see it in Maryland. We see it in New York. Very prominent in Wisconsin. Prominent in New Mexico. Texas. Colorado especially. Tennessee. Arkansas. Mississippi. All these southern states where the Democrats really needed to focus on. Illinois included. A lot of these states where representatives mattered and they gave the Democrats the majority. Yet they are no longer there. And they're not going to come back, especially for 2018. Right now, the Democrats could win by that margin in the popular vote and still only carry 229 seats. It seems impossible. Before, if Democrats were winning in the generic ballot by 8%, they were winning a number of districts. But looking down in the South, okay, we see a couple Democrats. We don't see any in Arkansas. We see one in Louisiana. We see one in Alabama. We see one in Mississippi. We see two in Tennessee. Compared back to when Democrats last held the United States House of Representatives in 2008, let's see if we can find it here. Right here, the last time Democrats held it, they had the majority in Arkansas, the majority in Mississippi, I believe that actually is the majority in Tennessee, the majority in North Carolina, the majority in West Virginia. A number of these races all of a sudden have flipped to the Republican side. And even with these polls on the Democratic side, up by 8%, according to the generic congressional vote on Real Clear Politics, the Democrats should be winning by larger margins, but they're not going to be able to, because looking at this map, looking at a number of these races, they're already rated as safe Republicans. So if they want a chance at winning back the majority, they could get it. But right now we have 210 Republicans in their column based off the Cook Political Report. It's trustable enough. You really do not expect the Republicans losing a number of seats like the Democrats did in 2010, in 2014, or the Republicans were able to in 2006. Looking at the numbers from 2006, that seems like the most realistic opportunity for Democrats. It just seems like they would slightly underperform that midterm year. So thank you guys for watching this video. Comment down suggestions below, and I will see you all tomorrow.